Okay, so today I'm going to teach you yung end game ng inyong magiging trading phase. Okay, so lahat ng student ko makakatanggap nito, so hindi lang ikaw. Okay, so now kailangan mong tandaan palagi yung sinabi ko sa inyo. You need to look for a 15 minutes time frame na highs and lows palagi, liquidities, highs and lows. Okay, so this is working on all sessions na meron kayo. Okay, and kung saan man yung ability ninyo makapag-trade ng silver bullet. Okay, so I believe na breakdown ko na rin sa inyo kung kailan yung mga silver bullet na yan. Okay, so just in case na makalimutan ninyo, this is the silver bullet. Na meron kayo. Okay? So from London session. Okay? May silver bullet kayo ng 3 to 4 PM Philippine Standard Time, okay? PH time. Okay? And then from pre NY session, meron kayong 7 o'clock, 7 to 8 30 PM PH time then. Okay? And then the New York session will be 10 to 11 PM PH time. Okay? So definitely ito yung mga session na yan. Okay, ito lang yung mga recommended ko sa inyo. Meron pa namang iba pero still hindi ko na i-recommend yon since masyado nang madaling araw yun dito sa Pilipinas. So definitely baka mahirapan lang kayo ma-trade yon. So this is the recommended silver bullet na pwede nyo i-play out. Okay? So definitely that's it. So Kim, alin yung bago dito? Ngayon ko lang nalaman na meron palang pre-New York session na 7 to 8:30 PM Philippine Standard Time na silver bullet. Yes, meron po. Okay? So meron po tayong silver bullet ng 7 to 8:30 PM. Okay? Now, syempre para naman magkaroon tayo ng para maging valid 'to. Okay? So may ipi-play ako sa inyo na sinabi ni ICT na meron bagong silver bullet.
I give you a silver bullet model between 10 o'clock in the morning and 11 o'clock in the morning New York local time. That makes it so easy. So easy. You know when you're going to be trading. Before that, you didn't know what the hell you were doing. When is this stuff for him? I don't know. ICT's got a million videos. What are we supposed to do all this stuff? I don't know. It's too complicated. Let's go get me a moving average crossover and stochastics. That's a cop-out. I mean, I literally made it really easy for you. You have a silver bullet at 2 o'clock to 3 o'clock. You have a silver bullet at 3 o'clock to 4 o'clock, New York local time. You have one at 3 o'clock in the morning to 4 o'clock in the morning, London session. If you really, really want it, you can do 7 o'clock in the morning to 8:30. Yep. Love tucking them in there real deep in the videos. Guys don't want to stick around for a day.
Okay, so ulitin ko lang.
If you really, really want it, you can do 7 o'clock in the morning to 8:30. Yep, just love tucking them in there real deep in the videos.
Okay, so meron tayong silver bullet around 7 PM to 8:30 PM kung ito yung gusto ninyong i-trade. Okay, so I believe I did mention it to the Discord community na meron tayong silver bullet ng ganyan. So definitely hindi na yung bago para sa inyo. Okay, so now, excuse me. So now, i-breakdown ko kung paano nyo hahanapin yung mga silver bullet trades ninyo during this time session. Okay, i-breakdown ko sa inyo. So at first, pupunta po kayo palagi ng 15 minutes chart. Ulitin ko, hindi nyo kailangan pumunta ng weekly, daily, down to hourly, 4-hour, 2-hour, 3-hour, or whatsoever. All you need to do, open your chart, go to your 15 minutes chart. Okay, so ito yung mga takeaway notes. Okay, ilalagay ko yun dito. Takeaway notes, para naman ma-breakdown ko sa inyo lahat. This is the final. There you go, takeaway notes. So, ilalagay natin siya dito sa baba niyan. Okay, so, takeaway notes natin guys will be... There you go. There you go. So, lagay ko yan dyan. So, takeaway notes ninyo. time frame to look for always 15 minutes time frame. There you go. So time frame to look for always 15 minutes. Oh, but nawala yung 1. Sorry. Okay. So that's 15 minutes, okay? So now, during that time frame, okay, ang hahanapin po ninyo, huwag nyo nang tingnan yung pinakadulong-dulo or left side, sobrang layong left side. Again, hindi nyo kailangan yung lahat-lahat ng yon. Okay? Ang kailangan ninyo is makita yung buong concept ng ginagalawan ng market. It could be like this one. Okay? So, hindi nyo na kailangan pa mag-pull back or magtingin ng kung ano nangyari dito sa price action dito. Ang kukunin nyo lang is yung buong vicinity ng nakita ninyo sa 15 minutes chart. So, in this example, I'm going to give you like this. Okay? There you go. So now, once na meron kayong 15 minutes chart and nakita nyo to sa 15 minutes chart, now this will be your latest candle. This one, the black dot. So that will be your 15 minutes time frame ongoing candle. Okay? So now, once na nasa 15 minutes kayo, remember ha, 15 minutes time frame to, all you need to do is plot the highs and lows na na-create natin. Ulitin ko, plot the highest and lowest na nakuha ninyo. So that will you will call that one as a liquidity. So this one will be the buy side liquidity. Okay? So pwede yung pangalanan niyan diyan, then save niyo sa template para ita-type niyo na lang pala para ilalagay niyo na lang palagi, hindi na kayo mahirap mag-type. The bottom will be the sell side delivery or sell side liquidity. There you go. Once na meron na kayo nito sa 15 minutes chart, okay? It doesn't matter kung ano nakikita nyo dyan sa left side ninyo. Ang gusto ko lang tandaan ninyo, yung mga liquidities na nakikita ninyo. So in that case, pwede ko ba itong gamitin, Sir Kim? Yes, pwede mong gamitin to para lang ma-indicate mo na sell side taken siya sa 15 minutes chart. Now, kapag bumaba ka pa ng lower time frame, so i-highlight ko siya, guys. There you go. Gawin natin siyang yellow. Sorry, colorblind ako. There you go. So, isipin niyo that sa 15 minutes chart, 15 minutes time frame. Lagyan natin siya sa top. There you go. So that will be on your 15 minutes time frame. Now, syempre, mag-move tayo ng lower time frame. So now, ano magiging itsura nito sa lower time frame? Definitely this one. So, kapag nasa 15 minutes chart na kayo, okay? Ang tatandaan niyo is tingnan niyo kung may willingness ba yung market to move into this low or to that high. Naintindihan? I-monitor ninyo kung ano yung willingness ng market na puntahan. So, wala akong pakialam kung saan. It's just alamin mo kung ano yung dito sa dalawa. Naintindihan? It's either the up or down. That's why there's no such thing as prediction, guys. Walang prediction. It could do this one. Pwede niya tamaan tong sell side, then biglang tumaas. Or pwede siyang biglang tumaas sa buy side, then biglang bumaba. It depends. So, that is the time na pumunta ka sa lower time frame and hanapin mo kung anong willingness ng market. So, in this case, ang willingness ng market for me is, let's say for example, gusto niyang bumaba. Okay? There you go. Let's make it a red. So, now, once na bumaba yung market dito sa sell side, hindi ka mag-short. Okay? Now, ang kailangan mong makita is that, okay, ito yung kailangan ninyong i-keep that in mind. Okay, na-take natin yung sell side. Now, is there a willingness to the market to go up? Yun ang hanapin ninyo. Yun ang logic na kailangan ninyo. Like, tanungin yung sarili ninyo. Now, nakuha na yung sell side. Now, ano pa bang kailangan ko? Kailangan ko makita kung may willingness pa ba tong candle na to move the price higher. Naintindihan? Kung meron, long. Kung wala, wait for the confirmation and then short. Naintindihan ninyo? Ganun mag-play out ng silver bullet. Which is unknown yan sa majority of traders. So now, let's say for example, we do have a market structure pababa. Tinake natin ang sell side. Now, you want to see a reaction dito sa sell side na yan. I don't care kung anong klaseng reaction ang gusto mo, pero ang gusto kong reaction is that may candle na nagpo-push higher and then puro wicks sa ilalim. Naintindihan? Pwedeng maging wick. Pwedeng ganyan-ganyan. Hibla-hibla. Okay? The wicks do the damage, the body tells the story. Now, ilagay nyo yan dito. I-add nyo yan sa confirmation ninyo, sa takeaway notes ninyo. So, the body, the wicks do the damage, the body tells the narrative. Okay? There you go. So, time frame to look for, 15 minutes. The weeks do the damage, the body tells the narrative. Okay? And also, hanapin ninyo, ask yourself, after liquidity is taken, if there is a willingness of the masyado nang mahaba to, so ayan, ask yourself if there's a willingness to the market to go opposing, to go to the opposing liquidity. Okay, so again, there you go. So tanungin niyo yung sarili niyo after matake yung sell side kung meron bang willingness yung market to move into the opposing liquidity, which is opposing. Ibig sabihin, kung sell side to, opposing, ano bang kabaliktaran yan? Syempre buy side, tama? So hanapin niyo kung may willingness ba yung market to move into this buy side. Now ganito yung magiging itsura nun. If and only if meron, you'll consider this one as a break of structure. Kailangan mo maghanap ng mga break of structure. It could be this one. It could be this high. Or pinaka-best is ma-break tong high na to. In that case, wala na yon. Full potential of long na yon. Naintindihan ninyo? So in that case, you want to see the price breaking towards into that liquidities, smaller liquidities on a lower time frame. In that case, tignan mo kung magmumove ba yung presyo, kung babasagin niya ba itong mga zones na to. Ito yung isang way para masabi ninyo na ayaw niya nang bumaba kasi nga nagpo-pullback na yung presyo. In that case, that's a good reaction on a higher time frame. Naintindihan nyo? So, there you go. Now, let's say for example, this is the candlestick. There you go. Nagbe-break na siya ng mga ganyan. In that case, guys, you need to look for your fair value gap. Any! Kahit anong klaseng fair value gap yan, you trade that for long position, your stop loss will be the lows, of course, and target the opposing liquidity or 5 handles. Go here. Okay? So, once na naka-in position na kayo, just target 5 handles. It will always give you 5 handles per day. Naintindihan? So, now, in that case, you'll try to long that one out. Magpo-position kayo ng long somewhere around here. Right there. Then, your stop loss will be on this low or in this low. Okay? So, it depends on you. Now, once na meron ka ng stop loss, let's say, nag-position ka somewhere around here, and your target will be here. And now, your stop loss will be on that low. Okay? Ganyan lang. So now, once na meron ka ng silver bullet dito, in that case, you want to see the price move towards into that direction massively, impulsively. Ibig sabihin, mabilis. Okay? So now, ganyan yung magiging itsura ng market. Naiintindihan? Ganto ang gagalawan ng market. Now, i-highlight ko to ulit. There you go. Let's make it nice and neat. There you go. So now, this one will become your lower time frame. Okay? This is your lower time frame trading. So definitely, nagre-revolve to around 5 minutes, 3 minutes, 3 minutes, 2 minutes, and best is 1 minute time frame. Naintindihan? So ayan. So if you're going to ask me like, Sir Kim, anong time frame ba yan? Ganito ba? Ayun na, nakalagay na diyan. Okay? So definitely titingnan mo to on a 1 minute, 2 minutes, 3 minutes and 5 minutes time frame lang. Okay? So hindi ka po pwedeng mag-move ng 1 hour. Okay? Malilito ka na niyan. Naiintindihan ba? So, ito yung pinaka-whole concept ng market na ginagalawan palagi. Naiintindihan? So, ganyan kasimple. Now, lastly, okay, tandaan ninyo guys, nangyayari to, itong touch ng fair value gap and itong taken na to, simula po ng mga session na to. Naiintindihan? Itong mga oras na to. So, ibig sabihin guys, nagkukuha ng liquidity ang market kapag pasok ng oras na itong mga to. Naintindihan? Again, the objective is to go back into a liquid, to go back into the pair valley gap between that zone. Naintindihan? Between that zone. Yun yung idea nun. So, may papanood ako sa inyong video ni ICT explaining that one. So, ito yung video na to. So, bakit ko kailangan ipakita sa inyo to? Guys, kasi maraming tao nalilito sa pair valley gap and silver bullet. Kasi ang ginagawa nila, maghihintay sila ng 10 o'clock. Let's say, for example, ito yung 10 o'clock. Okay? Ito yung 10 o'clock. Then, may pair valley gap na kinerate, tinilong nila. Okay? Pwede yun. Okay? Pwede yun. Pero, paano kung walang pair valley gap na ito? Okay? Kasi minsan, guys, may binabalikan lang na pair valley gap yan. Let's say, for example, nandito yung pair valley gap. And then, bumalik siya dyan. Then, nalong yung price. Valid ba yon, Sir Kim? Eh, outside ng 10 to 11 yon. Kasi, outside to, diba? So, pwede po yon. And now, this is the video of ICT explaining that one.
Okay, so, what you don't understand is this is a silver bullet because it's using a fair value gap, even though the fair value gap is outside and before 10 o'clock. And this is part of the rules, so go back and listen to the recording. The fair value gap does not need to be inside of 10 to 11. The setup is a retracement into a fair value gap between 10 and 11. So,
naintindihan ninyo? So, ang setup is mag-retrace ang candle, mag-retrace ang price sa pair valley gap between 10 to 11, hindi mag-pair valley gap ng 10 to 11. Naintindihan? Ulitin natin.
Before 10 o'clock, and this is part of the rules, go back and listen to the recording. The fair value gap does not need to be inside of 10 to 11. The setup is a retracement into a fair value gap between 10 and 11. So, seeing that is the case, and we're seeing it rally up. If you didn't take this one in here, you could use this one, and it found its opportunity to drop down into consequent encroachment, which is midpoint of that gap here, with the expectation that we would see it at least run back to the previous day's settlement.
Okay. So, ganun kasimple. Okay? I hope naintindihan nyo na kung paano gumagana ngayon to. Okay? So, i-take note nyo yun. Okay? Wala kayong makikita ng recording niyan sa YouTube or whatsoever. Again, chinachap-chap ko lang yung mga recordings ni ICT na nagla-live siya. And hindi ko na rin kayang balikan yung mga live niyon since ang tatagal na nun. Okay? So, definitely, that's the gem for you guys. Okay? So, again, the idea is the market will go back to the fair value gap kahit outside yan ng 10 to 11 or outside pa yan ng 3 to 4. Pag binalikan yon, that's a silver bullet. Retracement from a pair valley gap between 10 to 11 and yung oras ninyo, yun ang silver bullet. Naintindihan? Yun ang silver bullet. Okay? So now, I think that's pretty much it for the silver bullet takeaway. Again, this is your one setup for life. Ito yung one setup for life na tinatawag ko. Okay? Again, ito yung i-perform ninyo araw-araw, minuminuto, sigu-sigundo, it will play out. Every single time, it will show. Every single time, it will play. Naintindihan? Now, a bonus one is inversion per valley gap. Pwede nyong gamitin dito sa silver bullet. Okay? So, inversion per valley gap can be used in this silver bullet once you're in, ba't nawala? Inversion per valley gap, ayan. Okay, naulit pala, sorry. Okay, so, inversion per valley gap can be used in this silver bullet. So, ibig sabihin guys, pwede nyong gamitin ang inversion per valley gap. Naintindihan? So, now, FBG. So, just want to clarify na itong ano na yan is a fair value gap. And this one will be your inversion fair value gap. There you go. Okay, let's make it a red one. Para halatang halata ninyo. Okay? So again, pag may nilagyan ako nito, definitely that's an per valley gap. And pag may nilagyan naman ako ng kulay pula, then definitely that will be your inversion per valley gap. Okay? So now, saan ka maghanap ng inversion? Dito ba? Dito? O dito? So definitely, pwede ka maghanap into this case. Kasi nga, makikita ka muna ng change of direction ng market, so definitely magiging bullish siya. So now, may makikreate na mga inversion per valley gap somewhere around here. Okay? Meron yon. Meron at meron yon. Okay? So now, once na nakapag-create ng fair value gap dito and nakikita mo binabasag niya na yan, definitely it will become what? An inversion fair value gap. So in that case, guys, you might wanna see it went through it and through it. Okay? I guess, ang rules ng inversion, the fair value gap, yung bearish and bullish fair value gap ninyo, pag nabasag yon, ma-account nyo lang as inversion fair value gap yon kung magte-trade yon papunta doon and babasagin niya yon. Okay? So, parang ganito yung concept ng inversion per valley gap. So, once na mayroon ka inversion, you want to see it traded to it and through it. Okay? Anong Tagalog nun? Ito daw ang market. Kailangan makita mo siyang mag-trade papunta doon and basagin yon, i-disrespect yon. In that case, it will become an inversion per valley gap. Now, kapag bumalik yan dyan, take note of the 50% consequent encouragement. That should be respected. Hindi dapat bumaba yung pressure dyan. Long position. You take that one as a long position. Stop loss will be the lows created on that inversion. Naintindihan? Simple as that. Ganun po mag-position ng inversion per valley gap. So now, in that case, this will become my inversion per valley gap. Retracement to that inversion will be a long position confirmed by a fair valley gap on that same time frame for long. And take profit will be here. Naintindihan? Simple as that. Pwede mong gamitin ang inversion per valley gap. That is the reason why maraming tao, pag nakakita ng per valley gap, sinushort nila yan, di nila alam inversion yan kasi babasagin yan. Nakapag-take on naman na liquidity eh. Okay? So, ito yung sinasabi kong what? Obvious run into a liquidity. Inobvious run niya yan sa liquidity and now, opposing liquidity naman ang target mo. Okay? So now, another scenario. So let's say for example, Sir Kim, yung market ng sell side liquidity is binabasag pa natin lalo. Paano na yon? In that case guys, same exact thing, hahanap ka ng fair value gap pero ang target mo na is yung dating price movement. Ibig sabihin, hanapin mo kung saan naglaro yung presyo way back before sa left side mo and that will be your target. So in that case, you might have a sell side liquidity here. And of course, dito, that you might wanna see it targeting. Naintindihan? Mas basic ba? So definitely, saan ka maghanap ng fair value gap? Definitely, into this zone, sa baba niyan. Then short. Papunta dyan sa sell side na yan. Naintindihan? Ganun lang pong kasimple and this is vice versa. Okay? So I think that's pretty much it. This is the last trading day. This is the last trading session for Silver Bullet. Hopefully, naintindihan nyo kung paano gumagana tong concept na to. Bin-breakdown ko sa inyo. This will be your one setup for life na pwede nyo gamitin time to time. It show up every single day it forms. Okay? Every single day it forms. Okay? Hopefully, maipasan nyo yung mga susunod nyo yung funded challenge and yung mga gagiging funded challenge ninyo. Again, once na perfect mo to, once na ma-play mo to araw-araw, okay? Just show up every single day to your charts. Napakasimple lang ang titignan mo palagi. Every time na may session ka, yan ang tignan mo. Ganito lang. It will play. Believe me. Napiplay ko yan eh. Okay? Napiplay namin yan sa Discord. Okay? And walang reason yun na hindi mo din siya maplay. Pare-pares lang naman tayo natutunan. And pare-pares lang naman itong naituro sa inyo. Okay? So again, I think that's pretty much it. This is the last video for Silver Bullet. Hope you're having a great day so far. That's it. Bye-bye. Peace out.